Steve, please can you just start by giving us your reaction to the game and the result?
Well, firstly, I congratulate Fiji upon their performance and deserved victory. They took their chances really well. We are bitterly disappointed. I think frustrated that we saw growth in some areas of our game, but other areas dropped off. And ultimately, if you miss that many tackles, fall off that many tackles against a team such as Fiji, they're going to score tries.
What is the direction of travel now? What is it you think you can do between now and Argentina?
Well, we have 2 weeks to be very focused on the performance that is what's required to beat Argentina. That's what matters now. And I think that we saw today, and we discussed earlier in the week, about the need for improvement and taking our opportunities. We saw some elements of improvement in that area. I thought the team started positively, but unfortunately made too many errors and then slipped off too many tackles.
Can I ask for a fitness update? And I realise you may have been asked this as part of the broadcast, but can we just confirm kind of where we're at with injuries? Because I realise, you know, you've said all week that following this game tonight, you'll then take a view as to who's able to travel to France. Are you able to update us on where we're at, please?
In terms of the update from what I gave you on Thursday, that hasn't changed. I am awaiting a medical report, as you'll understand. Players will be assessed over the next hour or two to have full understanding from today's game.
Thank you.
Hi, Steve. First ever defeat to Fiji and first defeat to a current Tier 2 side. A sort of stark statistic that you wouldn't have wanted. Is this one of England's worst days at Twickenham?
See, we're bitterly disappointed with it. I think credit them for an excellent performance. I think we knew they were a dangerous side before the game. They pushed France very hard last week in France, and they took their opportunities really well today. I think they're going to do very well at the World Cup, and I think there's a potential that we may meet them again in a few weeks' time.
I'm sure you can understand there'd be frustration from fans, and you know, I think they've probably sort of made their feelings clear, but you're still confident, like you said, the only thing that matters now is the performance and the game plan for Argentina. You're still confident that you can actually get that together and knock them over?
That is our focus, being ready for Argentina. We know they're a very good side. These games through August are there for purpose to ensure you're prepared for the tournament and understand the key areas you need to develop. And what was highlighted today was that we gave them too many opportunities, slipped off too many tackles. And that was very apparent. Argentina pose, whilst Argentina have got some power runners, they both pose a different challenge. So our plan will be steered very much and very clearly towards what's required to get the result against Argentina.
I know you're calm here, and I can appreciate that fully. Behind the scenes, are you angry?
I say everybody around the England team, the players, the coaches, the management, care deeply about the team, about English rugby. So we're very disappointed with the result today and aspects of the performance. However, what we do is it becomes very clear what we need to do to move forward over the next 2 weeks.
Courtney, congratulations on the 100 caps. Commiserations on the result. What's your kind of overview of what happened today?
Yeah, I mean, it's pretty disappointing, obviously. We just weren't good enough in terms of the tackle area. They've got some really good athletes, and they showed that today. And, you know, we let them get their offload game going. We paid for it.
What would your message to supporters be? Stick with you?
Yeah. Like I said last week, we're not going to give up, so... we're going to give everything we've got.
And 2 weeks now, obviously, to the big one. If you were to go out there and turn it around, I mean, how sweet would that be?
Yeah, that's the plan. That is the plan.
No, I'm very confident in all the people involved around the team, around the players, the coaches, the management. Today is not the result or an aspect of performance that we wanted. That is what is, and I think we are all disappointed by that. Now, what we need to do is ensure that in 2 weeks' time we're putting the performance that's required against Argentina. That's the focus, and and we've got a very talented group of players that I'm sure will play exceptionally well against Argentina. I thought he played, parts of his performance were very good. I thought he was great aerially, took that try exceptionally well. And I think that's what we've seen from Johnny May in England shirt for a long time. As I said, in terms of the wider 33, I'll confirm it as soon as I've got the confirmed medical report. And I was very transparent 2 days ago when I last spoke to media. Very simply, the only reason I didn't confirm it Thursday was I need to make sure everybody's fit post this game.
Will the only changes to the 33 be medical changes, or are you happy with everyone
else? As I said, I answered that same question on Thursday, and it's the same answer I gave on Thursday.
Steve, you covered a number of the crossroads as we come here. Is it a case now of looking at what you've got and continuing on the same path and trying to refine things and improve things? Or is there a point where you think, I've got to change things up, I've got to do things a little bit differently? How do you assess that?
I think we're very clear, and today's pointed out that a couple of other areas that we need to address over the next 2 weeks, and we'll make sure they're right for when we play against Argentina.
Do you think there's potentially a little bit of a power issue within England at the moment? No disrespect to any of the players, there's a little bit of field level tackles and so on and so forth. Is that something you've been looking at?
In terms of the players, I'm very happy with the squad we've got. I think we've got a really talented group of players, and the most important thing right now with the group we have, the players, the coaches and management, because I've been involved with other England teams before that have, under pressure and difficult circumstances, under adversity, which is some of the challenges we've faced the last few weeks, have come apart. What I sense is a group that is coming even tighter together, and we're looking forward to getting to France later on next week, and we're looking forward to getting into this World Cup. So we want, and I've been very clear on this previously, about the way we wish to attack, taking opportunities, the ball movement and using the edges, which we've seen some improvement last week, and I thought we saw some improvement again today. We also made too many mistakes. We've been very upfront about that. And test level, you can't make that number of errors. I'm very clear on what we're looking at for that game versus Argentina.
Steve, did you get a clear look at the Jamal incident?
It was cleared on the field, but you feel there may be
disciplinary issues there? Sorry, can you say that again, please? Jamal tackle, and did you get a clear look at it? It was cleared by the TMO, but it was quite outright again.
As ever, I'm not going to comment on it. I know you watched the game last night, and some of those things are a bit. You look at some of those incidents that happened last night, and it's quite surprising. And so, in terms of, I won't be commenting on anything of that aspect. I said beforehand in the week that the process we always respect. We find it quite bewildering what's happened over the last few weeks, and there's one or two things I found bewildering watching other games. But I'll just respect the process. Our focus is on playing against Argentina in 2 weeks, and it would be remiss to start me talking about any other aspect than that game, and you would expect me to do nothing other than focus upon ensuring the team is right to play against Argentina in 2 weeks. It's immaterial. That's not a point that I consider in any way and never do in any game. We are preparing against a very good Argentina side that just come out of the Rugby Championship, and I think we've got a great group of players that are very determined to get the result we want against them.
Just on that, is your instinct that there was system errors or effort errors or technique errors?
I think I've already answered that in the sense that we slipped off a lot of tackles, and they've got powerful runners who took the opportunities when they got them.
Absolutely torrential rain in the second quarter of the first half, and it seemed to have been reacted to those conditions. sometimes when you have that determination, you determine to be what you're trying to be, do you sometimes fall off that decision and react to those conditions when you're going
environment? I think when we rewatch that game, what we'll see is that we dropped contestable kicks, and which is unusual. And I think you'd agree that's unusual, because it's something that's usually been a real strength of the England team, particularly and particularly with somebody like Freddie Stewart at the back. Yeah, it's been a real strength. So we dropped contestable kicks and made then a loose handling error. And what that does, it gives a team like Fiji, who have so much pace and skill, it gives them an opportunity to break away. Will I be
following that fixture?
I'll be watching it, yes.
Thank you very much indeed.